So hi, everybody. This is Ria Davidson. I'm the co-founder of the Dragonfly Foundation, and I'm here today with a dragonfly dad named Jeremy. Hi, Jeremy.
Hi, Ria.
And thank you for coming today.
I'm very glad to be here.
So one of my favorite stories from a dragonfly family that we heard early on was she didn't like to ask for help because she would feel like if she said, can you go to the grocery store? Can you buy me some food? Sometimes the person that she would ask would stand there kind of looking at her, processing the request, going, oh, I have to take my own son here, or do I have time after work, or what could I make? So she decided that she would tell her friends and family and those in the neighborhood that she would put a flag in their front yard. And the flag in the front yard, she told them, meant that there was a red cooler for hot and a blue cooler for cold things on her porch. And so if people drove by and saw that there was a flag, they would know to go to the grocery store and to go put things in these red and blue coolers. And if the coolers got filled, she had stuff for her freezer. She loved that process, and the neighbors appreciated it too, because they could see when they needed help. It wasn't an imposition. They didn't have to ring the doorbell. And also, if, let's say, those coolers were empty, it made her feel like, well, maybe they didn't see it, instead of they said no or couldn't help me or I'm alone. It just was maybe they didn't see it. Maybe they took a different way to work that day, or they were so distracted with what was going on in their lives. So it's an easy way to share with people, not just with cancer, but those who are going through any kind of life challenges, or if someone loses someone that needs help, start a meal chain and suggest putting a flag in their front yard and a red and blue cooler. We have a book of tips that's on our website. You've seen the billboards too, the Dragonfly billboards.
Definitely.
What comes to mind when you see our Lamar advertising billboards?
The first thing that came to my mind was, obviously, I've seen the dragonfly with just the dragonfly on it. And these may still be out there. The ones, I believe it's Christopher or Christian. The little boy, I want to say he's about 10 or 11. He was on there. We were very close with their family at the time Aiden was in. And he actually even came over to one of Aiden's birthday parties. Aww. It touches me every time I see any of the billboards. That one was near and dear to my heart because it was somebody personal
that, you knew.
That was Aiden's little buddy. And, you know, they had both been through this battle together. But I love all the billboards, and I am grateful that the surrounding community is supporting. I don't know if they personally have children or family members going through cancer, but they obviously get it, that a lot of people have it in their mind. And I've talked a lot doing rideshare with people that, you know, a lot of people have it in their mind that, well, I want to support an organization that's helping to find a cure. And that's great. I don't take nothing away from that. There's people that's going through it right now that are benefiting from organizations such as Dragonfly.
Well, we want a cure too. We absolutely do. And we're so lucky to have Cincinnati Children's in our backyard. And Cincinnati Children's was recognized as the number one pediatric cancer hospital in the United States by U.S. News and World Report. They're miracle workers every single day. And we are so glad that people support research, that people support Cincinnati Children's. We're hopeful that people will continue to support our efforts to enhance quality of life and that help us do things for families today. People ask us, what's your mission and what exactly do you do? And how would you describe Dragonfly's mission?
Peace of mind would definitely be high on my thought process with that, because just coming out of winter, anybody listening to this can understand here in the next few weeks, you're going to be so excited to get out and do stuff with your kids. Just from a 6-7 month cold spell, we're talking about years. And to basically go from your kids being 1 year old to almost 4 years old now, our youngest, to go that long and no, we're not going to be able to go see Disney on Ice. No, we're not going to be able to go to the circus. We're not going to be able to go do everything else your friends at school are talking about they went and did. It gives you peace of mind. There is somebody that is helping us to be able to do that kind of stuff. Other than peace of mind, support. We do live a little far from the landing, but there's always been support there if we ever needed it. And not only support there, but support at the hospital. It could be wrong, but I believe Aiden got his Christmas gift from Dragonfly. And I will say, as a parent, it has been the biggest blessing to Aiden, who laid on his back in a hospital bed for 10 months, to have something to play on, to learn on, and to keep his mind occupied. And to keep him busy. The support basically anywhere you are. I know Sarah's received at critical times. She's received gift cards that helped out tremendously with a travel from Clifton to Aurora. When you're already struggling financially.
I know for fathers, it can be a big challenge. We've had many conversations with Dragonfly dads who feel exceptionally powerless in this process. Is there any particular piece of advice you have for other Dragonfly dads or other men who are going through supporting either their child or a loved one with a life-limiting illness?
My man-to-man's piece of advice would be always stay positive. Trust me, and if you think this is unmanly to cry, then I'm sorry to hear that. But if your child is going through any life-threatening ordeal and you don't ever find yourself alone at times, crying like a baby, you're missing out on something in life. And a family unit, and with that child, stay positive. Don't just be supportive and there for your child. Be there for your significant other in every aspect, and no matter what, stay positive and dwell on future hopes and dreams and ambitions, not on past, not on what ifs, not on the negativity, because that will bring you all down.
Is there something you'd like to say to our Dragonfly sponsors?
Thank you, thank you, thank you for all you do. You are helping more than you may ever know. And I think a lot of times, anytime you're sponsoring, you're doing any type of charity, you're doing any type of help, there's just always going to be more that whoever you're helping is getting from it than you may ever realize. And I could probably sit here with you, Ria, for the whole day and talk, and then when I leave from now, man, I wish I would have told her thanks for this, and it just slipped my mind. But a lot of times, just have a happy heart as sponsors to the Dragonfly, knowing that you're helping more than you might be possibly hearing that you're helping. It's not overlooked any whatsoever. It just may be unmentioned.
Jeremy's story is just one of thousands we have at Dragonfly. To hear more and learn more, subscribe to our podcasts, emails, and events.